दिस इज अबाउट द मिड सजेटल सेक्शन ऑफ द हेड एंड नेक रीजन शोविंग द लेटरल वॉल ऑफ द नोज ओरल कैविटी एज वेल एज द पार्ट ऑफ द नेसोफेरिंग्स ओरोफेरिंग्स एंड द
लैरिंगोफेरिंग्स
लेटरल वॉल ऑफ द नोज दिस इज मिडल कॉन्का इन्फीरियर कॉन्का यहाँ पे सुपीरियर कॉन्का होता है बराबर ये जो कट पोर्शन है वो तो दिस इज सुपीरियर मिएटस दिस इज मिडल मिएटस एंड दिस इज इन्फीरियर मिएटस इन द सुपीरियर मिएटस द ओपनिंग ऑफ द पोस्टीरियर एथमॉइडल एयर साइनसेस आर देयर इन द मिडल मिएटस इफ यू एलिवेट दिस मिडल कॉन्का डीप टू द मिडल कॉन्का दिस एलिवेशन इज कॉल्ड बुल्ला एथमॉइडल इन द बुल्ला देयर इज अ ओपनिंग ऑफ मिडल एथमॉइडल एयर साइनस बिलो द बुल्ला देयर इज अ सेमिलूनर सल्कस नोन एज हायटस सेमिलूनारिस In the anterior part of the hiatus semilunaris, the opening of the frontal air sinuses is there. In the middle part of the hiatus semilunaris, the opening of the anterior ethmoidal air sinuses is there. And the posterior part of the hiatus semilunaris, there will be an opening of the maxillary air sinus. So in the middle meatus, four openings are there. In the bulla, middle ethmoidal air sinus, and in hiatus semilunaris, from anterior to the posterior, frontal air sinus, anterior ethmoidal air sinus, and the maxillary air sinus. Below the inferior concha is a separate bone. Below the inferior concha lies the inferior meatus. Inside the inferior meatus, the opening of the nasal anterior part of it gives the opening of the nasal acrimal duct from the over the middle portion of the eye, from the middle canthus of the eye, deep to it lies a cavity known as nasal acrimal duct. So it opens into the anterior part of the inferior meatus. Below it, this is the hard palate. Posterior part of this part is known as the soft palate. This one is the uvula. Right? This is oral cavity. This is the tongue. This is fan shape, your genioglossus muscles. If you elevate the tongue, behind it lies the two fold, the anterior one fold. This fold is known as palatoglossal fold. Behind the palatoglossal fold, this fold is known as palatopharyngeal fold, and this depression is known as the tonsillar fossa. This is the posterior one third of the tongue, which is also shows the lingual tonsil over here. Behind it, this is the posterior most part of the tongue. This is your epiglottis. Between the epiglottis and the glottis, there is also epiglottic fold. This is the median glossoepiglottic fold. Lateral to it lies. This is the lateral glossoepiglottic fold. And this portion, depression part, is known as the valacula. This is the left side of the valacula, this one is the right side of the valacula, and it is elevation which is in the midline. So this is, you can say, the anterior surface of the epiglottis. This is the posterior surface of the epiglottis, which falls into the larynx. Okay. Further, if you see the lateral wall of the nose over here, this portion is known as nasopharynx. Inside the nasopharynx, you have got the tubal opening. This is eustachian tube opening or the auditory tube opening, which is guarded by the elevation known as tubal elevation. If you trace the posterior part of the tubal elevation, this fold is known as salpingopharyngeal fold. Deep to it lies the vertical muscle of the pharynx, that is salpingopharyngeus. So this is nasopharynx. Behind the oral cavity, this portion is known as oropharynx. This area is known as the oropharyngeal isthmus, and this area is known as the nasopharyngeal isthmus. This portion which lies behind the larynx is known as laryngopharynx. This area is known as the piriform fossa. The lateral to the this fold, periepiglottic fold, is known as piriform fossa or the smuggler's fossa. This is the location. Deep to the smuggler fossa lies the internal laryngeal nerve.